one day at a time. Sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking of you. Give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow may never be mine. Help me today, show me the way, one day at a time. I'm over human, I'm just a woman. Help me believe in what I could be and all that I am. Oh, show me the stairway that I have to climb. Lord, for my sake, teach me to take one day at a time. One day at a time, sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking of you. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow you walked among men. Well, Jesus, you know, if you're looking below, that is worse now than then. Oh, there's pushing and shoving, and it's crowding my mind. So, Lord, for my sake, teach me to take one day at a time. One day at a time, sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking of you. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, show me.
resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter days upon the earth, and we all shall see God, whom I shall see for myself, and my eyes shall behold, and that another. We brought nothing into this world, and it is certain we can carry nothing out. The Lord gave, and the Lord taketh away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hear my prayer, O Lord, and give ear unto my cry. Hold not thy peace at my tears, for I am a stranger with thee and a sojourner, as my fathers were. O spare me that I may recover strength before I go thence and be no more. Lord, thou hast been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, or ever thou hast formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. For 1,000 years in thy sight are as yesterday when it is past, and as a watch in the night. They are as asleep. In the morning they are like grass which grows up. In the evening it is cut down and withered. So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our heart unto wisdom. Amen. Please be seated. Good evening, everyone. I'm Pastor Richard Ricketts, and I'm the pastor of this ministry, Grace Church of Firstborn. On behalf of all of us here at Grace, I want to convey our sincere sympathy to the cousin's family. Sorrow and pain, grief and mourning is the price we paid for love. Death is the worst enemy. When death has come and taken our loved ones, it leaves our heart in pain. Therefore, we cry, we mourn, because we love our family. So we just want to let you know, families and friends, brothers and sisters, nieces and nephews, neighbors, family of this dear man whom we'll always remember, Cecil Paul Cousin. Our heart goes out to you all as you do mourn his death. Many years ago, right where this casket is, I was here, and I remembered we funeralize and memorialize the life and the legacy of his mother, Sister Cousin. Then a few years after, we came back and we did the same funeral service. I officiated his father's funeral service right in this house. We come this evening to give God thanks for his life and for his legacy, a son. Death is sure, but we give God thanks that Jesus already conquered death. The last time I saw him was at the funeral service of his father. We went to New Jersey that morning and we committed his body to the ground. Brother, cousin. Sister, cousin, brother, cousins were members of this church. I give God thanks for this beautiful family and for reaching out to us as a church to officiate the funeral service of Cecil Paul Cousin. So life must continue. How do we get over this? How do we proceed? We must be spiritual. We must think spiritual. The words of Jesus, as I read the obituary, I understand that he gave his heart to the Lord. Therefore, there is hope for him to live again. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. Do we believe? Death is not the end of man. Word of God says, unless a grain of corn die, it will not grow. So we trust God that as we come this evening to memorialize his legacy, I ask that you please stand as we sing the hymn on your program. Could we all please stand? Yes, I did mention we should put the hymn in the program. But however, it's on the board, right? The monitors. Sing the wondrous love of Jesus. Sing his mercies and his grace. In the mansion bright and blessed, he'll prepare for us a place. Everybody, when all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be when we all see Jesus. We will sing and shout the victory. Clouds will overspread the sky. But when traveling days are over, not a shadow, not a shine. Everybody, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. To heaven. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise God. Praise the Lord. I hope we don't let that make because of we are, you know, grieving. Amen. We can sing. All right. Amen. Praise God. Even though we are in pain, let us give God thanks. Amen. Whatever God does, amen. It, whatever God does is well done. We will not understand some things sometimes, but we can be upset with God. Is that all right? Amen. The Lord has called him home. And so therefore, we still must carry on. Is that all right? Praise ye the Lord. At this time, our dear Deacon Jervis Clark will come and take us to the throne of grace. Could you please remain standing? Close your eyes, bow your heads, as Deacon Clark will come and give us the opening prayer. Deacon Clark.
Oh God, our help in ages past, our hope for years to come, and shelter from the storm blast, unto our eternal home. O loving God in heaven, the creator of heaven and earth, hallelujah, the one who giveth life and one who take it away, we humbly come before thy presence this evening. Give your praise, we give your thanks, we give your honor. Hallelujah. All glory and praise belongeth unto you. Lord, here we are in your midst tonight. Lord, we come, dear Jesus, Lord, to pay our last respect to Cecil. Lord, we thank you for the life he lived. Lord Jesus, you see fit to call him home. Lord, and I thank you, Lord God, for everything that you have done for him. Oh God, you lend him to us, and you see fit to take him back home. And oh God, we come tonight, Lord God, Lord, to celebrate his legacy. We come, Lord God, to give you thanks, dear God, for all the life that he has lived. We know, dear Jesus, that the family are mourning. Hallelujah. It is hard to lose a loved one to the grave. But Lord Jesus, we know that you can comfort. You are the comforter. Lord, you said you will comfort those that mourn. And so, Lord, we leave the family into your hands, dear God. There is nothing we can do at this time to bring back Cecil. And, oh God, the place that he is now, Lord, he will not return. If he had a chance to come back, he would not come back. But, Lord God, we pray, dear God, that you would have thine own way. Lord Jesus, the place where he is at this time, there a place where there will be no sickness, no more pain, no more heartache. Lord, he is comfortable wherever he is at this time. So Lord, we just want to thank you tonight for your love and your care. Take the family in charge, dear God. Lord, they are mourning, but I pray, dear God, that you will comfort them. Give them peace, because it's only you alone can give that peace. Lord Jesus, oh Lord, take full control tonight. And Lord, whatever should be said and done tonight, let it all be done to the honor and to the glory of thy holy name. So have thine own way now, Lord, as we leave this rest of the service into your hand and tell your thanks in Jesus' name.
Amen. 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 Thank you much, Deacon Clark. Please be seated. As we continue giving God thanks for the life of this dear man, Cecil Cousin. At this time, we are going to have the reading of the New Testament scripture, 1 Corinthians chapter 15, 51 through 58, and Brother Clive Thomas will come and read for us.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Clive Thomas, very good friend of Cecil. You know, we go back about 15 years ago, and actually met him through my dad. You know, he used to work with my dad, and my dad introduced him to him, and we've been friends ever since. I just want to say my sincere and deepest condolences to the family and the friends that are here. If you know him, you know him. You know, he's a man, he's got a big heart. You know, as I said, it's sad to see him go, and I'm sure he touched everyone in this church at some point in their life. you know. But it's sad to see him go. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and going to read this. Now this I say, and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, neither doth corruption inherit in corruption. Behold, I shew you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on his incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this incorruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, by ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of in the work of the Lord, for as much as we knew that your labor is not in vain in the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
All right.
Praise the Lord. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Good job. Thank you so much. Praise God. For this we know that our labor shall not be in vain in the Lord. When you labor for the Lord, then you will be rewarded. Amen. Jesus said, let not your heart be troubled. He believed in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it was not so, I'd have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again. Praise ye the Lord. Hell is real, just as our heaven is real. Eternal life is real. We serve a real God. Amen. And so I join with the songwriter who says, everybody ought to know who Jesus is. Is that all right? Is that all right? Amen. Praise ye the Lord. At this time, our musician, Brother Shane Lewis, will give us a solo.
Oh, how much of the love Christ bought my fallen soul. He looked beyond my faults and saw my needs. He looked beyond my faults and saw my needs.
Praise the Lord. Greatest need to man is salvation. And Jesus, in his love, brings salvation to man. Therefore, the word of God says, it's appointed unto man once to die, and after death is the judgment. We give God thanks for the love of God. We give God thanks that his love for us will never end. Cecil, I'm sure that he had an encounter with God. He was raised by a godly mother and a godly father. I could tell you a lot about brother and sister cousin. Right in this ministry for many years, they served. They showed us how to love and how to serve God well. And I do believe that they passed on their spiritual legacy to their children. I trust that as we come this evening, of course, sad faces, painful hearts, I trust that we will search our heart and see where we stand with God. Because you see, funeral services are not only for the dead. Funeral services are for the living. It's a time to reflect. It's a time to make things right between you and your God. As a pastor of this ministry, throughout the years, I have officiated many funeral services. As I did mention, some years ago, I committed his mother and his father bodies to the ground. And tomorrow morning we will do likewise. But the Lord tarry, and tarry long enough, one of these days all of us will be gone. It is undebatable. If the Lord tarry long enough, all of us are going to face death. Therefore, it is right for us to make it right with God. At this time, we are going to have the reading of the second lesson, Psalm 90, 1 through 12, by Chavane, his niece.
The Lord has been our dwelling place in all generation. Before the mountains were brought forth, or ever thou hadest formed earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting. Thou art God. Thou turnest man into destruction, and saith, return ye children of men. For a thousand years in thy sight are but yesterday when it is past, and as a watch in the night, thou carriest them away as with a flood. They are as a sheep in the morning. They are like grass which groweth up in the even. It is cut down and withered. For we are consumed by thine anger, and by thy wrath we are troubled. Thou hast set our iniquities before thee, our secret sin in the light of thy conscience. For all our days are passed away in thy wrath. We spend our years as a tale that is told. The days of our years are threescore years in ten, and it is by reason of strength they are fourscore years. Yet it's their strength, labor, and sorrow, for it is soon cut off, and we are fly away. Who knoweth the power of thine anger? Even according to thy fury, so is thy wrath. So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our heart into wisdom.
Thank you, Max.
Thank you.
Good job. So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our heart unto wisdom. And Solomon told us that the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. Our days are numbered. If you tell somebody in the street that your days are numbered, maybe they want to fight you. But according to the word of God, our days are numbered. In this life, current life, we will not live forever in this current life. Word of God says, the years of man, threescore and ten, 70. And by reason of strength, you will live more. Therefore, we are to treat ourselves to wisdom. Thank you so much. There is a request from the family for a song, Now Until Then. And I asked my wife to please come, Minister Lydia Ricketts, and sing this song.
Praise the Lord. Let us praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise God. I hope this song will be a blessing. Praise God to you tonight. My heart can sing when I pause to remember a heartache. My heart.
so much, Minister. Yes. The soul of man is like a waiting falcon. When it is released, it is destined for the sky. That moment, says the soul was released. One of these days, you and I, whether you believe it or not, your soul will be released. But until then, with joy, we carry on. We give God thanks for the hope that we have. I understand that for some of us, funeral services are not the pleasant place for us. I must tell you, a lot of people are very uncomfortable in funeral services because some things will be said that you don't want to hear. But you see, the problem is we do not know which one of us will be the next. We do not know if it's you or if it's me. But take my word for it, one of us will be next. Because death is sure. But we give God thanks. Praise God that Jesus made the way for us. The only way a man go to hell, unless he reject Jesus as Lord and Savior. Praise God forever. John 3:16. For God so loved this world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. No matter your educational background, no matter your earthly position, we need to have a relationship with God, because we are on borrowed time. You are not your own. We will have to answer to God one day. May God help us. Give God thanks. It is said, as we will hear the obituary later on, that Cecil gave his heart to the Lord. Cecil turned his life over to God. Thank you so much again. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, we will be having some tributes. A lot of us, many of us, knew him for many, many years. Share joyful, joyous moment with him. We are going to give you the privilege to please come. The mic will be right here. And you are going to give a tribute, at least for 2 minutes.
Yeah, I just want to say something about my brother. I know he lived a full life, a good life. And, you know, death is unexpected. But he's no longer with us. But he's in a better place. And I know he really enjoyed his life and had a good. Yes, that's it.
The mic is open, tributes open, tributes. Time for you to say something about him. The mic is open.
Good evening. Good evening.
My name is Robert. Yeah, tribute to my brother. He's a loving guy. He loves to make jokes. I remember one time when we were having dinner. I gotta make sure I reach home before he does. Because when my mom would cook some fish, he would eat one side of the fish and turn it down. So when you come, you think you have a full fish. It's only a half. And there's a lot more with him. But he's a guy, if he's drinking a soda, everyone has to drink a soda. That's how he is. Very kind hearted guy. All right, thank you.
You're right. Thank you.
Good afternoon to everyone.
Good afternoon.
I see some of my longtime friend, and it's a sad moment, but I have to be here. I know Cecil from in the 70s. The Cecil father preached the message at William Street. That's how I met up with Christ, my Savior. And I just want to say condolence to the family, his brothers, and I believe one sister. And it's a sad moment, but it's a road we all have to travel. You know, I was about some 4 or 5 years now, I don't see sister. As back home, we all have nicknames for each other. We used to call him Marky B, and we call him Standby. That's what we do. Remember the last time I saw Cecil, that time I was living up by the top, and he used to work at a restaurant somewhere over there. And the time I come to New York, I wasn't working. And I woke him up and said, "Marky man, work at the restaurant, man. Come, you can't get food." So anytime I'm hungry, whether I'm hungry or not, I will pass by and I get a nice cup of plate of food. So I could make this opportunity pass me. I have to come say farewell to Cecil, and I hope and pray that he make it right with the Savior before he pass. Because I hear what he was sick, and he is from a Christian family. He know about God, he know about salvation. So I hope and pray that he gave his life to Christ before that sad moment come. Amen.
Amen.
Cecil was a good friend. I've known him for over 15 years. I met him through my dad, and I could say this since day one. You know, he's always been like a best friend. You know, always go out in the public with all his brothers, people thought, you know, he was my dad, I guess the ball head, I don't know what it was, but you know, he was literally always there. One thing I could say about him, he was very genuine, very dedicated. I've known him since he lived in Flatbush, East New York, Far Rockaway, Bronx. And, you know, I mean, listen, this man, he's been all over. And one thing I can say, he always finds some way to find me in Queens, you know, whether it's getting on a bus or taking a train or whatever it is. He's a man, he gets up like 4:30 in the morning. The first thing he does, most of the time, he calls me. You know, I always tell him I'm sleeping. But, you know, he gets up early. Hey, what's up, boss, man? How are you? Just checking on you, make sure you're good. And that means a lot. You know, and you know, he's big with his family. I know he always talk about Jennifer, you know, and I mean, I don't know how often he reaches out to his family, but he loves his family, one thing I can say. And as I said, he's gonna be deeply missed, not by me, but other friends we have in town with. I mean, a lot of them couldn't be here today because, you know, a couple of people, they were on vacation and, you know, they're actually working today. But, a lot of them said they'll be here tomorrow to pay their respects. But he's definitely going to be missed, and he was definitely loved by a lot of people. And I'm so happy to be here to actually meet most of his family. As I said, you know, may God rest his soul, and my deepest and sincere condolences to his family.
Thank you. Thank you so much again.
To my dearest Uncle Cecil, I will miss you so much. I'm going to miss the times that you run joke and tell me how my nose big like frying pan, and how my head big, and how my short and grow. I'm going to miss those happy days and the days that we were talking before you had got sick and turned for the worse, where God wanted you to do his job and his work. On behalf of me, Alicia A. Kerri-Ann, I want my family to keep strong and to find comfort in the arms of God. Yeah, he's able, he's a merciful God, and he will pull us through this time of mourning and grief.
At this time, we'll be having the reading of the obituary. His sister will come and read us. Put your hands together for her.
All right. Hello, everyone. I was supposed to come. Okay. I was supposed to come and give a tribute, but anyway, he's my bigger brother, and I miss him. But anyway, God know best. All righty. Cecil Paul Cousins was born to Janet and Robert Cousins on November 14, 1958 at Victoria Jubilee Hospital in Kingston, Jamaica, West Indies. He is survived by his daughter, Sophia, three grandchildren, sister, Jennifer, brother, Winston, Roderick, deceased, Cedric, Val, deceased, Earlington, Robert, and David, sister-in-law, Marcia, and Sylvia, nephews, nieces, uncles, aunt, cousins, and several friends. He attended Chatolda Park Primary School. and Kingston Senior Secondary School in Jamaica. Upon graduating, Cecil worked at Bank of Jamaica as a mail clerk. He worked as a chef at the restaurant in Uptown Kingston. Cecil also worked with his father doing tiling. In 1986, he immigrated with his brother Robert and Earl to live in Brooklyn. Brooklyn, New York. He worked at Ideal as a cutter for 3 years. He was a chef at Sammy's Restaurant and Crab Shanty in City Island in the Bronx. He worked as a mechanic, as a welder at Triport in Queens, New York. He enjoyed cooking. He enjoyed cooking. He would look in your pantry and make a delicious meal with whatever he found. He was called the kitchen jockey. Cecil used to go fishing with his brother and friends. He was an advent domino player. He would use his toes to pass dominoes to his friends. Dominoes to his domino partner. He was a friendly guy. I'm sorry, I don't have my glasses, so I have to be Quentin. If he is drinking a soda, if he was drinking sodas, he wants everyone to drink a soda. Cecil was easygoing. Cecil always got your back and his sibling. He also defended them when needed. He enjoyed dancing, a good laugh, and was the life of the party. And at times, he would have a few alcohol beverages. He was a loyal friend. His closest friends are Clive, the police officer, Dave, and Bella. Cecil had a full life, enjoying what he loved and spending time with family and friends. In the final part of the, Cecil returned his life over to God. That's about it.
Thank you so much, Jennifer, Cecil's sister. I am fully aware that this is hard time for the family because Cecil meant so much to them. But we are here for you. And we can assure you that we will be praying for you all, that the loving God we serve will give you strength in the time of your grief. I want to share a portion of God's word with us this evening. As I mentioned earlier, that funeral services are more so for the living. And it is very important for us to minister from the word of God at funeral services. I did mention that I am not well acquainted with, I was not well acquainted with Cecil. The last time I saw him was at the funeral service of his father some years ago, right here. But as I remembered, both parents, sister cousin and brother cousin, they were so godly. Brother cousin used to preach right on this platform. I've known him for many years. Wonderful man of God. Love the Lord. And I'm sure that he passed on godly heritage to his children. He was so much in love with dear sister cousin. He had only one name for her. Honey. Honey. Always talk about honey. Huh? The one in the jar? In the jar? She was sweeter than, she was much sweeter than that sister. Beautiful couple. Honey. He always called her. Never a time you see a frown. Brother and sister cousin, they serve in this ministry. And again, I say, I'm sure they passed on their godly legacy to their children. Now it's for them to make use of what they had passed on. But the prayer of our mothers and our fathers, the good thoughts of our parents, is not enough. Salvation is a personal matter between you and your God. Yes, they can pray for us. Yes, they can intercede for us. But I hear the songwriter said, everybody ought to know who Jesus is. Is that all right? Yes. Therefore, please give me 10 minutes more of your time. One of the wisest of all men was Solomon. Solomon was the son of King David. I remember as a little boy growing up, we always read the book of Solomon. So much that you find yourself quoting love words. When you are in love, you go to Solomon. Because Solomon would always tell you about love. Sometimes we would misinterpret it. The words of Solomon. Yes, he was the son of David, according to the scripture. Yes, God blessed him with wisdom. he had an encounter with God in his sleep. And God presented himself to him and said, make a request, Solomon. Make a wish. Whatever you wish, I'm going to grant unto you. And God spoke to Solomon as he was there sleeping. And God listened to Solomon as he made his request. He said, Lord, you know I have a nation to lead. Give me wisdom to lead this great nation aright. And after Solomon made his request to God, God scrutinized Solomon's request. He said, Solomon, you did not ask for the life of your enemies. You did not ask for riches. Therefore, I am going to make you rich. The things that you did not ask for, we are going to make sure you have all the wealth in the land. Therefore, Solomon became the richest of all time. The Queen of Sheba would send silver and gold to Solomon. And after a while, Solomon found himself drifting away from God. Even though he was the wisest of all men, even though he was the richest of all men, Solomon had more pleasures back then than all men. The Bible said Solomon had more women than all men back then. Solomon had 1,000 women. He led away into vanity. Solomon got carried away. Lose focus and turn to wealth. Turn to riches. Turn to women. Turn to vanity. How unhurt one woman, or one man rather, could have 700 wives and 300 sweethearts. Knowing that back then they did not have Pfizer to make that little blue pill. It's amazing. Solomon carried away into sin, grieved God. And as he reached the end of his days, he said something in the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 12. Two verses, the words of Solomon. Verse 13 and verse 14, Solomon wrote, let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep his commandments, for this is the whole duty of man. For God shall bring every work into judgment with every secret things, whether it be good or whether it be evil. I will talk to you on the subject, the old duty of man. Amen. The whole duty of man. Praise God. Yes. God created man for his own purpose. The sovereign God created man so that man would worship him. Man would acknowledge him. The Bible tells us in Genesis that God would come down in the cool of the day and have fellowship with man. Man was born, was created rather, in the dispensation of innocency. Man did not know sin. But because of disobedience, man has to step out of the presence of God. The Bible tells us that God would come down in the cool of the day and fellowship with man. God gave man a command what to do and what not to do. And therefore man disobeyed God and sinned against God. There is a consequence when we disobey God. When we sin against God, there will be a consequence. Therefore, man lost fellowship with the Almighty God. Man lost fellowship with the sovereign God. Therefore, man was put out of the Garden of Eden. But we give God thanks that it is not the will of God that man should perish. Last night in our Bible study, we talked about the second Adam. God gave us another man. Hallelujah. Praise ye the Lord. Who is referred to as the second Adam. That through him, man will have fellowship again with Almighty God. Solomon was well acquainted with the presence of God. God bless him in abundance. Wisdom, wealth, luxury he had. But he went astray. He stepped out of the will of God. Solomon had properties, goals, orchard. He had maidens. Men and women from all over the world would come and give to Solomon richest of all. But his heart turned away from God and turned to wealth, turned to lusts, turned to immoralities, turned away from God. Therefore, as Solomon enjoyed the fatness of his time, he enjoyed the pleasure of this time. Brothers and sisters, I want to admonish you upon the authority of God's word. Enjoy the fatness of earth. But remember, you are accountable to the Almighty God. You and I are accountable to the Almighty God. Cecil, live a good life according to what we were told. But the time came when something happened and his heart stopped beat. He was sick for a while, I understand. Was in the hospital, I understand. But the time came when his soul, as we heard the song earlier, like a waiting falcon, death approach, took him. Therefore, here we are this evening. Tomorrow morning, we are going to lay his body to rest. No matter what we are doing in life, brothers and sisters, make sure we find time to have a relationship with the Almighty God. And as Solomon enjoyed wealth and fame, the time came that Solomon reflect on his life. And he tells us, let us hear the conclusion of life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let us hear the entire conclusion of life. After Solomon looked, he sat down and he scrutinized his life. He remembered where God brought him from and the many blessings he accomplished. He remembered how he went astray. He realized that it did not worth it. It was just vanity and vexation of spirit. What does it profit a man to gain the whole world and to lose his one soul? Solomon came under conviction after he searched his soul. He said to himself, he said to you and I, let us hear the final phase of the of man. The whole matter of man is to fear God, have a relationship with God. Hallelujah. And to keep his commandment. For this is the whole duty of man. I trust to God, brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, before we die, we understand our responsibility to God. Moses called Israel. He said, oh, Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord. And thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thine heart. Hallelujah. We must have a relationship with God. We must have fellowship with God. We must love God. Because of his divine wisdom, he created man in his own image. We are accountable to the God of heaven. So yes, we can accomplish the best that earth can offer. Yes, we can have the best that earth can offer. But remember, we are accountable to Almighty God. Are you with me? Are you with me?
Yes.
Hallelujah. We are not our own. We belong to the sovereign God. So Moses tells the children of Israel, you must love thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy might. Amen. 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 Because death is no respecter of person. Death is no respecter of person. Yes, he was kind as I listened. They talk so much about him. He was a giver. He loved people. Amen. His parents left a godly heritage for him. And not only for him, but for the rest of children. Amen. Yes, he shared. He gave his heart to others. Hallelujah. Yes, he touched many lives. But all that he had accomplished, the last line of the obituary says, Cecil had a full life, enjoying what he loved and spending time with family and friends. Hear this, in the final part of his days, Cecil turned his life over to God. And that's what matters. That's what matters. Hallelujah. The Bible tells us that while Jesus was on the cross, there were two thieves hanging on the cross with him. And we know this story quite well. One of them went out of the harder, but the other said, Master, remember me when thou goest into thy kingdom. Jesus said, today, hallelujah, thou shalt be with me in paradise. Cecil gave his life, his heart, to the Lord in his final days. Therefore, it behooves him to live eternal life. Hallelujah. Family and friends, I share with you the word of God this evening. Solomon said, for God shall bring every work into judgment with every secret things. All things are bare and naked in the eyes of God. We cannot hide from God. We just cannot hide from the Almighty God. Therefore, God blesses us with beautiful jobs and educations and beautiful houses and money in the bank and beautiful family. I trust today, this evening, as we come to remember the life of this man, Cecil Paul Cousin, I trust that we will not focus just on him, but focus on our lives. Because remember, his mother, a few years ago, casket was right here. His father was right here. Today, he is here, his casket. Can't hear nothing we are saying. Tomorrow morning, we are going to commit his body to the ground, as I did years ago with his mother and with his father. One of these days, it will be you. It will be me. Where are you going to spend your eternity? After you leave earth, where will you spend your eternity? Eternal life or eternal damnation? I cannot tell you, and you can't tell me. You should know. Are you with me? It's appointed again, I repeat, unto man once to die, but after that, it's judgment. We can't cheat that. We can't cheat that. Death passed the king one day as he sat with all his royal gown and crown and fandangles. And death said, hey, you, tomorrow I'm coming to get you 12 o'clock. Mr. King, I'm coming to get you 12 o'clock tomorrow. The king said, oh my God, how am I going to cheat that? He called the gardener. He said, gardener, tomorrow 12 o'clock, I'm going to give you a treat. I'm going to take off all these nice, you know, crown and dresses you up and fix you up and let you feel what it is to be like a king tomorrow. The day when, the following day when death came, he saw somebody planting flowers at his side or somewhere near the gate. He said to him, "Hey, where is the king?" He said, "He's up there, sir. He's up there sitting on the throne." Death said, "Listen, I can't bother go up there, you come." What am I saying? We can't cheat death. But we give God thanks that Jesus conquered death. Hallelujah. Jesus said to Martha, "I am the resurrection and I am the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live." I conclude this evening that as we live here today, remember, it's appointed to man once to die, and after death is the judgment. Could we please stand? If there is one person here today, tonight, who are not certain of your salvation, I'm going to ask that you please raise your hand and let me pray for you. As we are going to sing the last song on the high and the program, and after we do that, I'm going to call the funeral director, because I'm sure that he has some information where we go next from here. Is that all right? When peace like a river attended my way, and some old man see it was thy coming we wait. Aside by thy grave is our goal. O trump of the angels, O voice of the Lord, blessed. Loving Father, God of all ages, we thank you for the creation of man. Lord, we thank you that by your perfect wisdom, you created man in your own image. After man failed through disobedience, Lord, you gave us the second Adam. We thank you for Jesus. Lord, we thank you for his miraculous birth. Lord, we thank you for the atoning death of Jesus. Father, we thank you for the triumphant resurrection of Jesus. Dear Lord, we thank you for the glorious return of Jesus. We thank you, O God, for the life and the legacy of Cecil. Lord, whom you have called home. Thank you, O God, that we were able to have known him. Thank you for the family life he touched, Lord. Thank you for the friends he touched, the neighbors, the co-workers, loved ones, O God. Father, he's not with us this evening. But whatever thou doest, Lord, you doest them best. And so as a family are grieving in pain this evening, I pray for comfort, Lord. You tell us in your words, blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. I pray for strength for this family. I pray for courage for this family. I pray, Lord, that you wrap your loving arms around them. Lord, I pray that they will work together, live together in love and unity, as they go through their time of grief. We thank you for the rich legacy of their mother and their father, brother and sister, cousin. I pray, God, that those who have not yet turned to Calvary, I pray, Lord, that they will give Christ a chance in their life. Even though, God, those who have heard your words this evening, Lord, let us understand the old duty of man is to fear God, have a relationship with God, and to keep his commandment. I pray, God, for backsliders will return. Sinners will confess and repent and look to you, Lord. Sovereign God, I pray, Lord, as we, Lord, come to the end of this service, I pray that, God, you'll be with us. And tomorrow morning, Lord, we'll be going over there to New Jersey. I pray, God, for your divine protection and guidance, Lord. Comfort us in the weeks and the months and the years ahead. And, Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus, that our life will be godly and found worthy to live eternal life. Be with us now, we pray, dear Lord, as we commit our lives into your hand. Thank you for the musician. Thank you for those who render their items. Thank you for the tributes. Thank you for the strength and the courage, oh God, of those who are able to come out this evening. Be with us, we pray, as we tell you thanks. In Jesus' name we all say, amen. 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 Thank you at this time. Praise God. The funeral director will come, and I guess they're going to be final viewing, and he will share some information with us. Thank you much. God bless you.
You can be seated.
Please, yes, thank you. You can be seated.
family and friends, as we bring to a close the homegoing service for our dear beloved brother, Cecil Paul Cousins. On behalf of the immediate family members, on behalf of Host and Freedom Service, I say thank you to Pastor Ricketts and also Elder Clark for their words and their prayers tonight. To the organist, Brother Lewis, and also Sister Ricketts for providing the wonderful selections. To all the well-wishers that are here again on behalf of the family members, I say thank you for taking the time to come out to support them, those that are here in person and those that join us by the live stream provided by the Grenadian Connection team. As indicated on the program, Cecil will be laid to rest tomorrow morning at Rose Hill Cemetery, which is located in Linden, New Jersey. For those of you that will be attending, we ask that you please be here about 8:30. The family has requested a second viewing tomorrow morning. And by 9:15, 9:30, we would like to be on the road with the procession heading on to Linden, New Jersey, where he will be laid to rest. After the interment at the cemetery, the family will be having a repast here. Jennifer, right? Where's Jennifer? Okay. Tomorrow after the interment, repast upstairs, correct? Okay. So again, you can pass the word. If you're not going to be here, you know someone that will be here, you let them know that they can feel free to come back here at Grace Church of the Firstborn, where they'll be fellowshipping, celebrating his life, and having some eats and drinks. At this point in time, I'm going to invite you to come forward and do a final and passing glimpse as we get ready to close out this homegoing celebration tonight. Amen. To the family members that are sitting on the front. I come just now to say.
The hour I first